Hello, Mr. Kher, and welcome to the Quint. You've gone out and called your performance as Dr. Manmohan Singh in The Accidental Prime Minister as the best performance of your life. Now, that's quite a loaded statement to make, considering that you've done over 500 films, you've been around for over 3 decades, you've done plays, TV shows. What made you make that statement with such conviction?
Because I think I found it very difficult to really do it well. That's why my first reaction of when the producers came to meet me and offered me this film, I said no. I think it's a knee-jerk reaction. You suddenly say no, I don't want to do it. Even though at that time I felt that it will be controversial, why get into something this? And I don't know, I was also making a transition to work abroad and things were happening. So my first reaction was, let me not get into this. I had previously also criticized Dr. Manmohan Singh. I said, now they will say, why is he doing so? All those thoughts. And I was sitting at home and watching news, and I saw Dr. Manmohan Singh on news. And he was going from one place to another place. And I said, let me see how he walks. And I tried in my sitting room, and I was a disaster. I could not get anything right. And then I tried for another half an hour. It did not happen. So it intrigued me as an actor. I said, this is going to be interesting if I get to. So I asked them for the script, and then I read the script, and then I saw some YouTube footage, and I asked them that I need at least 6 to 7 months to, you cannot start the shooting with. I have never worked so hard for any character. Means the maximum that I worked hard was for Maine Gandhi Ko Nahi Mara, because I was portraying an Alzheimer patient. So I really had to do research, practice, do hard work. But this took about 6 to 7 months to get into the character. And because Dr. Manmohan Singh is not somebody who happened in black and white era, whose pictures we see. He is current. He's since yesterday he was on a book launch.
Right.
So it's, and he's on television, he's in everybody's psyche. You can't go wrong. And there's a very thin line between caricature and the person being portrayed well. That's why I said, and it took me about 2 to 3 months to get his voice correct. Because Dr. Manmohan Singh is not expressive at all. You have never seen any of his still where he is laughing. Or he is like this.
Yeah.
You will see everybody's picture, whether it's Gandhi, whether Nehru, Mr. Modi, every Indira Gandhi, you will see all the politicians, actors, anybody worldwide who will have some still or the other. But Dr. Manmohan Singh will be one expression.
You were aware that people will be scrutinizing you because you're playing somebody who is still very much there in the public eye.
Exactly. And also he has the same expression for anger, for hurt, for pleasure, for happiness, for you name an emotion.
So was that an easy thing?
No,
was
that was the most difficult. And yet he has to convey everything. Even in a trailer, there are 5 different emotions. It does get across. So it was I had to go through to drama school training all over again. And I have never, I don't believe in method acting much. But I had to internalize the whole thing. I had to create an atmosphere around me. I had told everybody that please address me as Mr. Prime Minister. My sign outside my makeup room was Prime Minister of India, not Anupam Kher. It's a great exercise.
There is, of course, talk that there is a political agenda behind this film. At any other time, probably it would have been less. It would have probably been seen as a neutral film based on Mr. Sanjay Baru's book. But since this is the election year, and also, I think because the BJP's official Twitter handle tweeted the video of the trailer with some glowing remarks, it's now being seen as, you know, acha, is there a political agenda behind this film? Do you think that retweeting of that trailer helped or harmed the film in any way?
It was a political masterstroke by them. What else do you expect from politicians? All politicians, all political parties will thrive on something like this. I'm nobody to comment on this because people will perceive what they need to perceive in any case. They say that Anupam Kher is Mr. Modi's admirer. His wife is a BJP MP. Akshay Khanna's father was Vinod Khanna, who was a BJP thing. There was some money which came from this thing. So we cannot stop from those people. But it's not the first time that has happened. I remember when Udta Punjab was into problem and Akali Dal and BJP was in Punjab, every political party, every political leader, including top leaders of today of Congress and other parties, did say that. To suddenly sort of say that political parties ko aisa nahi karna chahiye, we are expecting too much. They will do that, and I think maybe they did it because that's how this whole question will come up. But ऐसा नहीं है कि हमने makers ने कहा बीजेपी को फोन करके कि आप हमारा retweet कर दो. Why is everybody surprised that this film is coming before election? When else do you it should come? This is the best time for a film like this to come. Every producer makes a film for a certain point. We make patriotic films to be released on 15th of August, 26th of January. We make holiday films in for Christmas. We make Diwali, Eid films, etc. We need to get out of it. Like we have gotten out of this whole syndrome of pretending to sort of we see a political film without the real names. We need to also get out of this thing that we need to make films which are political background should be released in election times.
Right. Now, initially, the Congress reacted to the trailer and said that, you know, they would demand for a ban on the film. They would want to watch the film before it's released. And now they've come to a conclusion, or they've come to an approach where they say that they have no problem and they will not do ban the screening of the film, or even demand for an early screening of the
again,
film for the
political
party.
Farsightedness.
So how do you react to this change?
Smartness. I think they're very smart because they discovered that if they are going to create problems for this film, they will come across as people who are sort of scared of a film. So similarly, I think the way BJP tweeted this film, saying this thing, I think they, after an initial reaction to that, hame picture dikhao, uske baad bhi, they sort of suddenly said that, no, we should not see it. So these are the games that politicians play. In the process, I think, our film is getting noticed. It's a smart thing on their part. I think that because Mr. Rahul Gandhi had said during sacred games that we should not use that. And it's a smart move. It is going to upset them further when the film comes out. Hope they continue to sort of be the champions of freedom of expression.
Now, what's really significant about the accident of the Prime Minister is that for the first time you're seeing political leaders still alive who are being portrayed in a story, in a drama, in a political drama, and it's not like a, you know, biopic which is lauding a certain person or something. There are grey shades to it, you know, and we are in a country where, you know, even a film like Padmavati today, you know, can cause controversy for months to end. What is your take when it comes to making films based on real people and, you know, real events, be it political figures or religious figures?
I think it's art and cinema cannot function the way politically correct things need to happen. It's not the first time that there is an agitation that has happened, whether it's Padmavat or whether this film or any other film. There are people have killed people because of some what they thought was not the interpretation of art, cinema, theater. But that should not stop anybody. I think that's the biggest achievement of this film, that people have been named. It's not that you are looking at Dr. Manmohan Singh look-alike kind of a person and you are calling him Ram Mohan Singh.
No.
An audience is pretending that, oh, actually toh ye Manmohan Singh hai, magar hum inka naam achha audience picture walon ne Ram Mohan Singh rakha hai. So I think in 70 years, we have moved on in so many departments, so many areas. It's important to move on in cinema also.
As an actor, as a filmmaker, and as a former chairperson of the CBFC, I want to know, shouldn't the CBFC also have a uniform rule for films which are depicting real people, political parties? Because you had an earlier chairperson who said that you cannot show anybody who's real, you'll have to bring their signature, you'll have to have an NOC from them. There were films which were banned because they were showing a certain political party or, you know, BJP, or a documentary which showed Mr. Modi in certain light. But, you know, then a certain kind of film gets greenlit. Shouldn't we also have a system where films are viewed objectively without any kind of discrimination, whether it's coming from this wing or that wing?
Of course it should be. I think the whole book about censor board has to be revisited. I don't know what has happened about the Shyam Benegal committee, which sort of whether that has got implemented or not. I was CBFC chief in 2004. the whole in my tenure, the two films which were the most controversial was, which I thought very important, that Black Friday needed to be passed because it had got stuck. Having said that, I think, and also in today's time, digital you can see everything. You can't be careful about it. But we are also a very vast country. We are of various religions, various classes, various food habits. Anybody can sort of say that it does not agree with me. It's not only the political parties which sort of object to it. It can be a religious sect, it can be anybody who can sort of react to it and sort of say that. But I think we are making progress. This film is a prime example of that. We have made a progress.
How do you think Dr. Manmohan Singh will react to the film? Or if you want to give him a message before the film releases, what would it be?
I can only give this message to Dr. Manmohan Singh that if he genuinely watches and in his heart of heart, even if he acknowledges to himself that this is the best portrayal of him, it will not be an exaggeration. Dr. Manmohan Singh is already known, but he will be loved after this film, because cinema has that magic that when you show a vulnerability of a person, when you show the weakness also even a person, your heart goes out to the person like that. In cinema, that is the joy of it. The loneliness, when you read it in a book, that in the corridor Dr. Manmohan Singh walked with a little tiredness, in a book you don't see that. But in a long time, long frame, when you see Dr. Manmohan Singh walking alone in night in his residence, and there is a chord of piano going on, your heart will go out to him. You will want inko ghar le aate hain, inka dhyan rakhte hain. I get worried sometimes because I'm talking before the film is released, but I would like him to see the film and invite me for a cup of tea. He should do that.
Let's hope that cup of tea happens. Now, my last question is, you had a certain perception of Dr. Manmohan Singh before you began the film, or
yes,
probably read the book.
Yes.
And then you went through this journey where you enacted him, were him. What was the change that you found in your perception of the former Prime Minister during this period of
that
months?
He became a victim of his surroundings. There is no way that I will say that he was uncorruptible individually. What I felt that he was very vulnerable. He was very real, stubborn also. There is a certain amount of stubbornness in his characterization. And also, I think growing up also means that you change perception of people. When I went through this whole rigmarole of living his persona for almost a year, I felt he's lonely, but he did his best to make things work. And that's why there is a lot of love that will come across in my performance, not necessarily for him, but in portraying him. I think that's the change that has happened. A lot of people said when I initially tweeted about it that I felt there is a change in my perception about him, and history will not judge him wrongly, because that's what he said in the last press conference. A lot of people said, "Ab agar picture release hone wali hai, now he's changing his thing." What I thought about earlier, that's what growing up is all about. I still feel that what happened between 2004 and 2014 was, my God, frightening. All the scams came out, 2G, 3G, 4G, CWG, all those things are happening. I was part of India Against Corruption. So it's not that suddenly we are waking up, ki we are showing something which did not happen. We lived that era. Like we are living a certain era, people are talking about certain things. Similarly, if somebody wants to make a film about today's present situation, they are most welcome to make it. But that happened. He was called a remote control prime minister. He was called a silent man. So it has not come across as a surprise. But I still want to tell through you and through Quint that he will invite me for a cup of tea after this film is released.
Okay. Thank you so much for talking to us, and all the very best for the
Thank you. Pleasure.